Hi, I'm Lucilla Ronai, and welcome to the Conservation Starter. Like many people around the world, I'm finding myself working from home. This is an opportunity for me to bring conservation to you. First of all, what is conservation? It's really not what you think. Conservation, sometimes known as art conservation or cultural material conservation, is all about looking after items, usually old and treasured items, to make sure they last. So it's done by a conservator, which is me, and I repair and preserve cultural material and artifacts with a bit of science and a lot of laughing. Conservators work in galleries, libraries, archives, and museums, and we call this the glam sector. We can also work in private practice, working with people with their individual personal items to make sure they last. We work with absolutely everything, any material you can think of that has been made, any material that has been collected by a museum, you can bet it's been conserved at some point. This includes really ancient materials to really modern materials. For example, parchment, papyrus, books and paper, ceramics, metal, glass, wood, textiles, but also plastics and audiovisual material and even digital items, what we call born digital items. For myself, I particularly work with paper, photographs and books, and have been known to clean a helicopter or two. So conservation can take a really hands-on approach, and this involves the direct treatment of objects to mitigate, prevent, or if it's sometimes ethically sound, even reverse changes that have happened to objects over time. I can flatten a piece of paper that's been all crumpled. I can repair a tear and reunite the edges so it doesn't even really appear like a tear was there to begin with. I can also wash acidic degradation out of paper so it removes all the yellow byproducts and means the paper lasts. We use a lot of weird and wonderful tools and equipment in conservation to make this happen. And we borrow this from pretty much every industry. For example, my favorite tool is a septum elevator, usually used by surgeons in nose surgery. We also use a lot of scientific equipment, including beakers, chemicals and solvents. We work in a science laboratory. Also, conservation takes a really hands-off approach, and this is all about preventing damage from happening in the first place. For example, we control the temperature and relative humidity that objects are stored in or displayed in. Relative humidity is the moisture content of the air. So heat and moisture can really accelerate chemical deterioration processes, because if you think about it, aging is a chemical process. So by controlling the temperature and humidity and making sure it's optimal for the object, it means it will last for longer. Other things that we control is the light levels, and we try and make sure they're appropriate for the object to last, because for example, some materials like paper and textiles are really susceptible to light damage. The paper can yellow over time, also the inks and the handwriting can fade depending on the light. So you might have wondered why some museums are really dark. That's probably because they have paper or textiles on display and they will really make sure they last. Whether taking a hands-on or a hands-off approach, conservation is all about managing change to cultural material, whether that's physical or chemical changes. So if it's anything to do with caring for an object, conservation and conservators will be involved. So the purpose of the Conservation Starter is to spread the word about conservation and how it can help you. So subscribe if you want weekly tips and tricks on how to care for your treasures and your old family heirlooms. If you want some reasons why sticky tape is the absolute worst, to get some answers to the questions, why do conservators always appear to wear gloves? And to get a behind the scenes look at galleries, libraries, archives, and museums. Oh, and of course, get some conservation simple tricks you can try at home. We're going to explore so many different things about conservation together. So come on a journey with me and start a conversation about conservation. Let me know in the comments if there's particular things you want to learn about and know how to care for. Welcome to the Conservation Starter, where we save the world one piece of paper at a time.